So it's almost time to crunch and munch, because Tripwire released the official Maneater launch trailer yesterday. Now along with that, I have some information about some DLC that could be coming down the road for Maneater. Hey guys, this is Chris with B&B Gaming. Welcome back, and I hope you're doing amazing today. Thank you for taking the time to check out this video, and thank you for your likes, your shares, your comments. Definitely appreciate all the support. Now to start with guys, I'm going to play the official Maneater launch trailer.
This season on Maneater, everyone's biting off more than they can chew.
Oh, look at you!
The depths will be discovered. The food chain will be disrupted. And the drama will get deadly. Because down here, things always evolve. And the hunter becomes the hunted.
That's the one who took my hand, all right. Get yourself ready, boy.
Maneater. Eat the people, save the world.
So to start with guys, I have a PSA for you. If you're ordering Maneater through the Epic Store, you can actually use the coupon for the Epic Mega Sale or whatever it's called. That $10 coupon, you can use it for Maneater. The thing is, it's not going to work until May 22nd. So possibly a good idea if you pre-ordered it is actually just cancel your pre-order. Wait until May 22nd, buy it, apply the $10 coupon, and save yourself $10. So over the last couple weeks, Tripwire has been doing different live streams previewing Maneater and giving us more information about the game. The first thing we've learned about are the grottos. So with the grottos, this is essentially just a, I guess, safe space for your shark. Anyways, each one of the seven regions is going to have a grotto. Now, if you die in Maneater, you're going to respawn in that region's grotto. Another feature of the grottos is once you unlock one, you're going to be able to fast travel back and forth between whichever ones you've unlocked. Another feature of the grottos is this is where you're going to upgrade your shark, buy new evolutions, upgrade your evolutions, etc. And another important thing we learned about the grottos is once you enter a grotto, all the wildlife in that region, and they didn't say people, so I'm not sure about the people life, but anyways, the wildlife is going to respawn and repopulate that area. Now, as far as gameplay in Maneater, we've learned a couple important things. First thing is how we heal in Maneater is by consuming wildlife. And I'm not sure if people count as this or if it's just like turtles and fish and stuff. Another thing we've learned is that the size and mass of your shark play a big role in Maneater. So they're saying you can fight anything at any growth stage in Maneater and win, but it's going to be a really challenging fight because what happens is your size determines how much damage you do and how much damage you take. So if you're like level 2 and you're fighting a level 10 crocodile, that croc's probably going to kill you in one or two bites, and it's probably going to take you 10 or 20 to kill that crocodile. So if you're an elite player, I think you definitely are going to have a good challenge with this game. Now, another important thing to know about combat in Maneater is you can actually escape these predators. So if you have like a level 20 crocodile chasing you around and you're a level 2 or something, if you swim far enough and fast enough, you'll actually get out of their territory and they'll stop pursuing you. And actually, the same thing goes for the human bounty hunters as well. You can actually escape them and kind of like GTA, they'll be searching for you. And finally, they'll give up the search and, you know, go back to port and have a couple beers or whatever they do. Now, as far as DLC for Maneater, they've kind of explained where they're at as far as developing it. The first thing they said is there's not going to be any special skins or other species, etc. that you can buy at launch. So there's not going to be all of a sudden 20 loot boxes full of neon shark skins or anything. Basically, you buy Maneater, it's going to be the whole game. As far as the pre-order bonus, the Tiger Shark adaptation, they said they're going to be working on offering it to other platforms later on. Now, as far as the development process for DLC for Maneater, they said a team actually broke off from the main development team for Maneater, I don't know, a couple weeks ago or something, and they've been basically prototyping different post-launch DLC ideas. As far as when we can expect Maneater DLC, they said more than likely it's not going to be days and weeks, more like months, but they have said that they're going to be really looking for our feedback and looking for what we really want from them, and that's going to help steer the direction of the game. As far as what types of DLC they're looking at for Maneater, they said they're looking at adding more combative and non-combative wildlife, more story, more areas, but again, they're prototyping it, so they're going to, you know, see how it goes. Now, in the live streams, they were asked a couple different questions about DLC they could add. One question was about, are they going to be doing seasonal events like Killing Floor 2? And they said they're not going to be doing those for Maneater. Another question was asked about Maneater and multiplayer. Will they be adding it? And they said they don't have any plans to add multiplayer to Maneater. But they also said that if Maneater does really, really well, that, you know, never say never. Another question was asked about modding support at launch, and they confirmed that they're not going to have modding support at launch. And I don't remember if they said they're going to be adding it later or not, but essentially at launch, it's not going to happen. Now, another piece of information we got was, what can we expect as far as game length? How long is Maneater? And basically what they said was, an experienced player, so someone that really knows the game, it takes 10 or more hours to complete the whole game. Now, for probably me, probably 15, maybe 20 hours, because, you know, I like to get all the collectibles, I want to do all the side missions, etc. So what do you guys think about Maneater? Are you getting hyped up for this game? Let me know in the comments below. For me, Tripwire actually sent me a preview copy of Maneater, or gave me a code or whatever, and I downloaded it, and it's sitting on my Xbox right now as I'm making this video, and just thinking about it, I'm getting excited. Now, I can't actually make videos about it until Thursday, or I can make them and not publish them until Thursday, but I don't know, man. This is perfect timing for me because I ran out of games to play, and I've been bored, and I'm like, oh, I need a new game, and then Tripwire Stone contacted me on Twitter and said, hey man, you want a copy of Maneater? I'm like, yeah. So a shout out to Tripwire and Maneater for their great community support.